Cancer has been the leading cause of death in Japan for a long time, taking the lives of almost 400,000 people annually. While the advent of various therapies have significantly improved the survival rate of cancer patients, cancer relapse remains as a major impediment that prevents complete cure of the disease. One of the prominent characteristics of cancer cells is that they grow fast inside a patient's body. Hence, drugs used in today's chemotherapy typically target fast-growing cells. However, in recent studies, some cancer cells have been identified to grow slowly and thus remain undamaged inside the patient's body despite the treatment. The cells that survive the treatment have been attributed to cause relapse weeks, months, and even years after the treatment. What makes them grow slowly? What genetic characteristics do they have? And ultimately, what exactly is the biological mechanism of treatment resistance and cancer relapse? There's still a lot to be unraveled about cancer cells, especially about those that grow slowly. To answer some of the questions that I just mentioned, it is imperative that we isolate and analyze hundreds and thousands of slowly growing cancer cells, which was impractical and inefficient using conventional method. The goal of my research is to develop an efficient method for carrying out that task. Specifically, I use a microscale laboratory technique called droplet microfluidics. In droplet microfluidics, we generate millions of small droplets with a diameter of about 100 micrometer, which is about the average thickness of a person's hair. We encapsulate individual cancer cells into these small droplets and observe their activity. And because cells are encapsulated, when cells grow and divide during incubation, all of the cells will remain inside the same confined space. This allows us to distinguish cells that grow slowly from those that grow fast, and ultimately select out the slowly growing cancer cells for downstream analysis. So far, my colleagues and I have developed a technique that enables fast sorting of droplets. We have achieved a sorting rate of 4,400 droplets per second, which is fast enough to observe a vast amount of cancer cells in a practical time frame. I plan to use this high-speed technique to observe a lot of cancer cells, identify the slowly growing ones, and biologically analyze them. Ultimately, through my research, I expect to identify the characteristics and vulnerability of slowly growing cancer cells, which could be used to elucidate the mechanism of cancer relapse. Furthermore, that information could be used to develop anti-cancer drugs with lower risk of relapse in the future. Thank you.